Hello, everyone. This is Elder David Glover, CEO and founder of Majestic Productions. Have a good day. May God richly bless you. You're in for a packed full 2-hour session. Be encouraged. Don't give up. Don't give out. And stay focused. Walk in your destiny. You are vessels of honor, meet for the Master's use. You are someone uniquely and wonderfully made. You are a man or woman walking in your destiny. Walk in your abundance. Walk in your divine enablement. And I am really glad to have a chance to bring these messages to you. Number one, the sponsor I just acquired is Christian Nobel. Now, all of you know about the Furs in Regency Parkway. Okay? Now, the owner is Tyler Ray in Regency. Furs is reasonably priced, and what it is this. They have many pieces of fur. Fox, mink, sable, coyote, and other different degrees. The people buy the coats. They make the pieces or cut the pieces off. You can get a vest, coyote vest, mink vest, sable vest, or sable, whatever you might want. You come in to try the coat on. They, in turn, will take your measurements. Ergonomically affordable means they can make a vest for you for a few hundred dollars, and you can put it on layaway. Now, you know, generally, that doesn't happen. You go to Overland, you're going to pay whatever the price is, thousands of dollars down. No, you pay thousands of dollars, that's it. Coyote vest on sale is $1,600. Normally, it's $2,000 or more. Well, Tyler is a man that is a family-owned business. He's been in Omaha all of his life, and he wants to give back to the community. So I encourage you. You can go up to Regency and walk in Christian Nobel. They always have advertisements every so often about furs that they have and so on. So just be bold. Go up and talk to them, and they're more than happy to let you try on the minks, sables, coyote, whatever. And you can get an excellent deal on a fur vest or a fur coat. Now, I recommend you take it to them after the season. Connect with them. Be responsible enough, because I've seen too many fur coats damaged, torn parts of the fur. That's because people don't take the fur back and get it repaired or get it conditioned. That's only about $70. Now, if you got a fur coat, you can definitely afford to get it reconditioned to do whatever you need to do to keep it up. Now, I move on to Steve's Barbecue Pit. Now, I've got to say, with Tyler, he's an awesome man. He's giving back to the community, and he works with youth. He was a coach for quite a few years. So now, Steve's Barbecue. Catering at 2414 Patrick's Avenue. Omaha, Nebraska, 68111. His hours are Monday, Wednesday through Saturday. He's closed Monday and Tuesday, 11 a.m. to 8 p.m. Sundays from 3 to 6. Now, you can do a full rack of ribs for $20.60. Well, I understand that's an excellent price because no one's doing it that reasonable. Then you can get a half rack for $14. Whole chickens smoked for $10.60. Half a chicken for $8. Now, I'm going to take a, not a goose. Yeah, no, a goose. I'm going to take a goose. No, a duck. Baker's has them. I'm going to take a duck and two hens. The duck and one of the hens, I'm going to have for Christmas. And the duck is going to be frozen for later on for New Year's. Now, you can do pork loins, half a loin for $15.40. Eighth of a loin for $9.60. Also, he has cheesy potatoes, coleslaw, potato salad, baked beans, beans, cheesy potato mix. So go by and see Steve. Tell him David Glover sent you. And tell Steve David Glover sent you when you go in to inquire about the fur coats. Because he's a man on a mission to bless people with quality furs, and at reasonable prices. Now, Red City Brothers Auto, they're located at 2601 North 72nd Street here in Omaha, Nebraska. Go by, see them. Now, they can got the simple clean, they got the super clean, and the premium clean. The simple is $89, super clean is $99, premium clean is $109. Each one is more involved than the other. Now, they take pride in producing quality work and providing their customers with excellent service. They do have the most affordable prices in town. They'll even pick up your car and deliver it to you. Like you coming in from out of town, you'll have a good opportunity to connect with them for their service on your vehicle. And last but not least, we got Wolf Brothers down on Dodge Street. Tom Kurtzenbaum, been in business. He took it over from his father. Wolf Brothers Western Wear, since 1950, 7001 Dodge Street. Since 1950, as I said, the phone number is 402-556-558-3005. Fine Corinthian leather smell when you come into the establishment. Layaway, exotic boots, Western Wear, chaps, all the things of the Western attire. And the bottom line is, he has layaway to where you can put money down on it and take it once you pay for it. Now, I encourage you, go by and see these vendors. They are quality men and women. The women do work with them. They're quality products. I wouldn't be advertising it if they weren't. Now, on with the message. The theme of this message today is redeem the time. Redeem. One, to recover property by discharging an obligation. Two, to ransom free or rescue by paying a price. Three, to free from the confines of sin. To be free from the consequences of sin. Four, to remove the obligation of by payment to convert into something of value. Three, that in particular to use before objectives functioning as nouns. Two, three, to what extent? Three, to that extent. Time. A period during which an action process or condition exists or continues. Leisure. Three, a point or period when something occurs. A set or customary moment. I'll be back in a moment. Sorry about that, viewing audience. I had to go get something to wet my whistle. Now, back to the message. A point period when something occurs, a set or customary moment, an hour for something to occur. It's so important to value the time you have for any task or anything. You see, life is so very important that you never want to waste it. You see, God wants all mankind, excuse me, redeemed unto him. Galatians 4, verse 5 to 6, to redeem them that are under the law, that we might receive the adoption of sons. And because ye are sons, God hath set forth the Spirit of his Son into your hearts, crying, Abba, Father. So see, that's what the Father God looks at. He wants all mankind redeemed unto him, because see, every man and woman on this planet has a purpose, destiny, and has a divine assignment. God wants you to fulfill, because he's created you in his image for his reasonable service. You see, every man or woman on this planet is important to God and has a unique purpose and destiny, all his or her own, that no one can fulfill it but them. You see, God has set it up that way. You all are special and precious and uniquely and wonderfully made by God for his good pleasure. Philippians 2:13, for it is God which worketh in you to will and to do his good pleasure. You must look at yourself as a man or woman of character and integrity, a vessel of honor meet for the master's use. See, you are special and precious to God the Father. He cares about you, and he's made man in his image and woman in man's image. But you've got to believe in yourself. You've got to believe that you can. You can't let stinking thinking knuckleheads hinder you from your destiny. And you've got to work on one accord with the Father of lights, with whom there's no variableness, neither shadow of turning. You are special and precious and uniquely and wonderfully made by God for his good pleasure. Philippians 2:13, for it is God which worketh in you to will and to do of his good pleasure. And see, once you have committed intimate relationship with him, you don't mind doing his good pleasure, because he's going to bless you exceeding and abundantly above all that you would ask or think. You must look at yourself as a man of character and integrity, a vessel of honor, meet for the master's use. You see, that's why reading self-improvement books is so important and mandatory if you are to be all that you can be, because, see, reading those books gives you a positive, strong, determined, and committed self-image of yourself. You see, the books change a stinking thinking mindset into a productive and powerful and confident, positive, and productive mindset, and enable you to love yourself. I know there's different men and women that don't love themselves, don't feel good about themselves. They can be handsome. The women maybe are beautiful, but they don't feel beautiful about themselves. You see, you've got to look at yourself from the right perspective. Then, when you do, no one can take away from you what you know about yourself. You see, you become who you think you are. You begin to believe in yourself. You feel good about yourself. You respect yourself. And others see the change in you and begin to respect you as well. People respect the man or woman that carry themselves with integrity, class, divine insight, wisdom. They know how to hold their peace. They're not running their mouth every chance they get about nothing. Like James Brown used to say, like a dull knife, just ain't cutting. Talking loud and saying nothing. You begin to know who you are, where you're going, and you begin to know that nothing and no one can stop you but you yourself. You begin to see yourself from a whole new perspective, a man, a woman of power and authority, far beyond those of mortal men. You look at life from a whole different perspective. You begin to realize that you can do anything you set your mind to do as long as your motives are right. Philippians 4:13, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. You see, if you can believe for it, you can and will receive it. You see, it's yours and it's got your name on it. Whatever it is you want, it's yours, and it's yours for the taking. You got to take your situation. You got to make it happen. You can't sit back and hope it's going to happen. You see, as you learn to love you, the man you are, you won't feel alone and lonely. Your life will take on a higher conscious level. I'm going to give you an example, viewing audience and listening audience. I'm single. I stay at Crown Tower. And it's an apartment. I'm preparing to go through Omaha 100. They have classes that is called Family Housing Authority. I'll go in on the 12th of April. I'll go in for a Saturday. I chose that because that's the only time I work out on Saturdays. But that day, I'm willing to take off. I'll go in for 5 hours until the app from 8 to 5. Well, it's a little longer. It's about 9 hours, 9 or 8. But I buy a book, spend $25 for this manual. They'll teach out of the manual. That requires them to give me a certificate of completion. Then they will pay my down payment when I'm ready to move. The bank will loan me so much money, but I have to buy a home within a 4-month window. So I complete the class in April. I probably have May, June, July, August. Well, I'll find the right house in that amount of time. Then HUD works it like this. Whatever house you want, you have an inspector come out and inspect the house. He gives information to HUD what has to be done. The owner has to repair that at his own expense. Then you can move into the house. Last house I had, they had to put a sump pump in it and fix the railing. Then I was able to move in. But see, I'm so contented with where I'm at doing these broadcasts. I'm on Cox Cable and on 1690 AM, the one. Next week, we'll be on FM live streamed as well as AM live stream. So the bottom line is, God's moving awesomely in my life, and he's given me furniture, bedroom furniture, living room furniture, coffee table, blessed me to have a car. Now I look at, I'm going to move possibly, well, next year, hopefully by the summer. Well, the bottom line is, I'm not thinking about a relationship until I get in my house, get things established, finances established, to where I get resources from broadcasting, contracts on doing this work, voiceovers, advertisement, whatever is involved. I'm contracted on that. Then, once I'm established, then I'll be open to have relationship with the woman that's like-minded. The universe will send her in. And she'll probably be of a different culture because I know where I'm going. I need somebody in my life that can appreciate me, understand where I'm going, is involved somewhat in broadcasting, has understanding of it, or is doing it to where we have a divine connection and we can work with one another. And see, I also have Majestic Enterprises, that's another area of business. Well, see, I'm an entrepreneur. I'm a businessman. And my wife has to understand business in order to have a relationship with me. Because if she doesn't, there's no chance that we'll be together. See, I'll be very aware of the type of wife that I've got to have. I'm not going to accept just anything. If you can't appreciate fur coats, you can't appreciate wealth, you can't appreciate diamond rings and other things, then you don't belong with me because I'm going to have those things. The wealth of the wicked is laid up for the just. I have some now, and I'm going to have more as time goes on. But I'm investing into my life and into myself so that way I can be a better man, have more resources and investments. Invest into your life. Invest into yourself. That way you can be all that you're ordained on the planet to be and to move forth in faith. You see, when you realize who you are and flow in your purpose, you don't think of some or like or live the same. You don't think the same or live the same. You achieve more out of life. Life takes on a whole new perspective. And you begin to expect God's abundance. You think above, not beneath. You don't look at just getting by and just doing enough. You're selfish. You're not willing to step out and do anything. You only concern with yourself. Well, you got to be concerned with more than that to have wealth and to do what it takes to obtain it, to work with it, and to accomplish it. Because it's your destiny at stake, your purpose, and you got to know who you are in order to achieve it. You don't become anxious. You enjoy the journey. You realize you have a destination to follow, and you are encouraged that you will arrive unscathed and that the joy of the Lord is your strength. Life is for you to live and have fun, to laugh and manifest your greatness. See, if you don't feel good about yourself, you can't laugh. Nothing's funny to you. You feel miserable. You feel down. And you got a critical spirit and always talking bad about somebody. I was around a lady that was like that for 3.5 years. God allowed me to be around her to know what I don't need and don't want. Critical spirit, always complaining, always putting you down, always finding negative things to say. Text you about 5 minutes, nothing but negative texts back to back to back. I'm so thankful I'm free from that. It was a beautiful woman. She was a sweetie's culture. But the bottom line, mindset messed up, mentally unstable, health issues. I have no time for that. My wife is going to be strong, sober-minded, know who she is in God, have her children in check, and parents and grandparents. Cut out spoiling children, because you make them at a point they lazy and they're not getting up off their behind, getting out, being responsible. I'll never spoil a woman. I'll never have one that is, because she's not responsible. She expects everything to be given her. Now, you are a valuable man or woman. You are what you think you are. Abound in your abundance. Never look down on yourself and think that you're worthless. You are the master of your game plan, and it's your responsibility to fulfill it. Become all that you can be as a servant with no selfish ambitions. Service is your rent to occupy space on the planet. Now, you must become your own best friend, not your own worst enemy. And if you do, I'll see you at the top. Because look, where else do you have to go? Where are you going? And what is your destination? Well, if you ain't selfish, if you're selfless, you're willing to reach out to others in any capacity, any culture groups, anyone or anything that you're impressed to reach out to and help. Now, you have to make the decision for all these things to come to pass. But if you do, you'll be blessed and everything will come together for you. And everything will come together for you. That may take a little time. It may take patience, long-suffering, and endurance. But you will make it. And your life will change for the better. But you got to work at it to maintain it. Like in relationships, men have to work with women and enhance them. Men have to speak into their lives like their wives and love them, show them that they are somebody, speak prophetically into them to where they can feel better about themselves. And men have eyes for that woman. Women have eyes for that man. But you got to have the right motives to be involved with that man. And you got to know where you're going. I say over and over again, men, have your business together. If you got a business, get a business account so you can put money into that account. Have resources. Invest into your life. Have mutual funds. Have understanding of passive residual income. Women, the same thing. Because then when you connect with a man, you can connect for the right reasons. You both are about purpose. You both are about destiny. You both know who you are. You both know where you're going. And you don't fall short. Then you could take your sexual energy while you're single, put it into sexual transmutation to enable you to take care of everything you got to, not depending on some woman to do for you, not depending on some man to take care of you. Take care of yourself. Get off your lazy butt. Get busy. Get down. Be resourceful. Be a man or woman of character and integrity. Read self-improvement books. The Secret of Being Great, I'm going into that in a few minutes. But you become who you think you are, and you become confident in yourself and your ability and skill. The ladder to success is never crowded at the top. Imagination is the workshop of the mind. Organized planning is the crystallization of desire into action. Now, thoughts are things, truly, thoughts are things, and powerful at that. When they are mixed with definiteness of purpose, persistence, and a burning desire for their translation into riches for other material objectives. Desire, the starting point of all achievement, the first step towards riches. Whatever the mind of man can conceive and believe, he can achieve. Now, I'm going to pause to go into this book by The Science of Greatness by Wallace D. Wattles. This book was written in 1911, and it's an awesome book to help you understand you. Identification. Having recognized God as the advancing presence in nature, society, and your fellow man, and harmonized himself with all these, and having consecrated yourself to that within you which impels towards the greatest and highest of the next step is to become aware of and recognize fully the fact that the principle of power within you is God Himself. Now, all you idiots out there that don't believe in God, don't want God, and you're going to do your thing, read this again. The principal power within you is God Himself. You must consciously identify yourself with the highest. It is not some false or untrue position to be assumed. It is a fact to be recognized. You are already one with God. You want to become consciously aware of it. There's one substance, the source of all things, and this substance has within itself the power that creates all things. All power is inherent in it. This substance is conscious and thinks. It works with perfect understanding and intelligence. You know that this is so because you know the substance of exists and that consciousness exists and that it must be substance that is conscious. Man is conscious and thinks. Man is substance. He must be substance, else he is nothing and does not exist at all. If man is substance and thinks and is conscious, then he is a conscious substance. It is not conceivable that there should be more than one conscious substance. So man is the original substance, the source of all life and power embodied in a physical form. Man cannot be something different from God. The intelligence is one and the same everywhere and must be everywhere and a tribute of the same substance. There cannot be one kind of intelligence in God and another kind of intelligence in man. Intelligence can only be in intelligent substance, and intelligent substance is God. Man is one and the same with God, because God created man in his image. And so all the talents, powers, and possibilities that are in God are in man, not just in a few exceptional men, but in everyone. All power is given to man in heaven and on earth. It is not written, ye are gods. The principle of power in man is man himself. And man himself is God, because he's a little god, demigod. But while man is original substance and has within him all power and possibilities, his conscious mind is limited. He does not know where all there is to know, and so he is liable to error and mistake. To save himself from these, he must unite his mind to that outside him. There is a mind surrounding him on every side, closer than breathing, nearer than the hands and feet, and in his mind is the memory of all that has happened, that has ever happened, from the greatest convulsion of nature in prehistoric days to the fall of a sparrow in this present time. And all that is in existence now is now as well. Held in this mind is the great purpose that is behind all nature, and so it knows what is going to be. Man is surrounded by a mind that knows all there is to know, past, present, and to come. Everything that man has said or done or written is present there. Man is in the same one identical stuff with his mind, is present there. Man is of the same one identical stuff with this mind. He proceeded from it, and he can do so, and he can so identify himself with it that he may know what it knows. My Father is greater than I, said Jesus. I come to him. I and my Father are one. He shows the Son all things. The Spirit shall guide you into all truth. Your identification of yourself with the infinite must be accomplished by conscious recognition on your part. Recognizing it as a fact that is only God, and that all intelligence is the one substance you must affirm somewhere after this wise. There is only one, that one is everywhere. I surrender myself to conscious unity with the highest. Not I, but the Father. I will to be with the Supreme and to lead the divine life. I am one with the infinite consciousness. There is but one mind, and I am that mind. I speak that unto you am. I that speak that unto you am he. See, you can be incredibly positive in life, but you've got to know who you are, where you're going. You've got to make a decision to do what it takes to achieve your destiny, to walk in your greatness, and to renew your mind, to read books that help you think on a higher conscious level, that enable you to go for your greatness, that help you help yourself to reach your potential. And men and women, children, everyone out there in the viewing audience has potential. Some of you may be 60 and 70, you still have potential. Some of you may be 60 and 70, you still have purpose. And that is waiting on the inside of you for you to make the decision. You're going to do all it takes to achieve it. You're going to do what it takes to get there. You're going to be walking in your greatness. But see, it takes you to work on it, you to handle it, you to make the decision to go for it. So that way you can acquire what you desire. Now, the next message is, remain committed, stay focused. Remain, one, to be left after others have been removed, subtracted, or destroyed. Two, to be something shown, done, or treated. Three, to stay after others have gone, to continue unchanged. Committed, to put in trust. In trust. Two, to put in a prison or mental institution. Three, to transfer, consign, to carry into action. Stay, a strong rope or wire used to support a mass. Two, guide. Three, stop, halt, a resistance or sojourn in a place. 5, prop, support. 6, to hold up. Focus. To bring or come to a focus. 2, center. 3, adjust the focus of. The theme to my message says it all. Remain committed, stay focused. You first must know yourself and be committed to your dream and remain committed and remain focused to complete any task or goal to make it. You see, viewing audience, you must believe in yourself and God that with His anointing, you will succeed to succeed. Now realize, you can succeed to fail. That's by not planning your work and working your plan. See, if you don't plan what you're going to do, successful leaders plan their work and work their plan because they have a destiny, they know they have a goal, and they want to achieve it. Well, if you procrastinate, take time, and don't get on top of it, you can't achieve nothing because you're not willing to do what it takes. You're not willing to pursue your destiny. And I realize it takes time, takes effort, energy, and you got to be focused. You got to be willing to not give in, not give up, not quit, and know who you are and know what it takes and be willing to do whatever you've got to do to fulfill your purpose. Too many people are dumb enough to think things will just come together by luck and happen by luck. But realize, luck is your preparation and opportunity, bam, coming together. You see, it's all up to you to achieve your destiny and pursue your purpose. You are who you think you are. You are created in God's image and likeness. Genesis 1, 26 through 27. And God said, let us make man in our image, after our likeness, and let them have dominion over the fish of the sea, over the fowl of the air. So God created man in his image, in his image created he him, male and female created he them. You see, God looks at you with such a high regard and appreciation. So what's wrong with you? Why do you look at yourself any less than he does? Why do you put yourself down, doubt yourself, and not believe in yourself, and then say, well, it's never going to happen. It's always going to be messed up. It's always been that way. This life has been horrible. Well, I want to tell you, I don't ever come up with that mess. I'll never say that. I say it in regards of symbolizing what I'm talking about. Because, see, I know who I am. I'm walking in my destiny. I'm in my purpose. I'm focused. I'm committed. And I'll never give up, never give in, never quit, and I'll stay ever ready to abound in my greatness. But then I know who I am. I know who I am becoming. I know where I'm going. I'm in my destiny, my purpose, and I am contented where I'm at. That's why I never, and I do mean never, get tired of referring to reading self-improvement books, because they give you a more productive and positive self-image. Too many of you people out there in the viewing audience, live-streamed audience, you feel bad about you. You don't like you. You can't stand you. You hate you. Well, you're your own worst enemy. You're always going to put yourself down. You're always going to speak ill about yourself. You're never going to speak life until you change the stinking thinking, negative mindset that you have and come up to being positive, focused, and committed. But then, too, you don't have envy. You don't have jealousy against somebody. And you're not selfish. You only want things for yourself. You see, viewing audience, when you're confident and love yourself, believe in yourself, your life takes on a whole new perspective, and you think positive about yourself and speak positive. You stop letting stinking thinking people dictate your life and always put you down. You are what you think you are. You stop letting them tell you what to do, how to do it. You look at what you've got to take care of and you fulfill it. Always keep your head up, chest back, chest out, back straight. Get your swagger on. Feel proud of yourself. Feel confident that you can make it. You begin to walk in authority. You become confident, and doubt, insecurity, fears don't even enter your thoughts. You see, God cares about you. 1 John, 3 John chapter 1, 2. Beloved, I wish above all things that thou mayest prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. See, God thinks more about you than you think about yourself. He loves you more unconditionally than you could ever love or give love, because God is love, and his love is from everlasting to everlasting. Beloved, I wish above all things I'll prosper and be in health, even as thy soul prosper. Let go of past mistakes, failures, and mess. Begin to develop a functional and consistent behavioral pattern. You see, you are who you think you are. Abound in your greatness. Never doubt yourself. Always continue moving forward. You are uniquely and wonderfully made. Keep your mind evolving for positive involvement to come into your life. Never quit. Never give up. Always be optimistic. Stand and deliver truth. Keep your eyes upon the prize. Be strong and of a good courage. Remain focused and steadfast. Be the man or woman that Christ has ordained you to be. You must have self-confidence, for without it, you doubt yourself, hate yourself, never forgive yourself, much less other people that do you wrong. You must also love God and honor him. And viewing audience, if you honor God and yourself, you buy cologne for yourself if you're not allergic to it. You dress sharp. You go out and buy clothes that are compatible with you, that show the type of man that you are or woman. You clean up, boot up, suit up. Be the best you can be. Be all that you can be. Remember, I can do all things through Christ, which strengthens me. Love yourself and love God. And as you do, I'll see you at the top. Because really, you have nowhere else to go but the top, because that's where your destiny lies. That's where your purpose is. And that's what you want to do to maintain and to accomplish everything you're on the planet for. I must admit, it's been a joy reading self-improvement books to where I improve my mindset, to where I think on a higher level, to where I walk and talk in a way that my destiny is coming. I love what I do, and I'm aware of what I do, and I know how important it is for me to accomplish my destiny and my purpose. That's why I'm on the planet. And I thank God for everything that I have, everything he's blessed me with. And I appreciate him for being my God and Father, and I love him. I really love him because he first loved me. Now I'm going to share some information here with you. Desire, the starting point of all achievement, first step towards riches. Now see, I'll give you a heads up. See, Edward C. Barnes was a man that he wanted to work with. He wanted to be a business partner of Thomas Alva Edison. He took the risk. He did whatever he had to do to get there. He had a burning desire in his heart to be his business associate, and he wouldn't take no for an answer. He was focused. He burned bridges to get his dream to pass. The starting point of all achievement, the first step towards riches. Now, this is in the book Napoleon Hill, Think and Grow Rich. When Edward C. Barnes climbed down from the freight train in Orange, New Jersey, more than 50 years ago, he may have resembled a tramp, but his thoughts were those of a king. He believed in himself. He knew he could make it. He made his way through the railroad tracks to Thomas Alva Edison's office. His mind was present. He heard himself asking Mr. Edison for an opportunity to carry out the one consuming obsession of his life, a burning desire to become the business associate of the great inventor. Barnes' desire was not a hope. It was not a wish. It was a keen, pulsating desire which transcended everything else. It was definite. A few years later, Edward C. Barnes again stood before Edison in the same office where he first met the inventor. This time his desire with Edison, the dominating reality of his life, had become a reality. Barnes succeeded because he chose a definite goal. Placed all his energy, all his willpower, all his effort, everything back of his goal. The man who burns bridges. 5 years passed before the chance he had been seeking made its appearance. And I'll share something with you. You are the one that builds your dominion. You're the one that has to work at it. See, opportunity a lot of times sneaks in the back door. It does not call you. It just happens, and you got to be ready to latch on to it. You got to be willing to go into your abundance. The man who burned bridges, 5 years passed before the chances he had been seeking made its appearance. To everyone except himself, he appeared only another cog in the Edison business wheel. But in his own mind, he was the partner of Edison every minute of the time. From the very day that he first went to work there, it was a remarkable illustration of the power of a definite desire. Barnes won his goal because he wanted to be a business association of Edison. More than he wanted anything else. He created a plan with which to attain that purpose, but he burned all bridges behind him. He stood by which his desire until it became a dominating obsession of his life. And finally, a fact. When he went to Orange, he did not say to himself, "I will try to induce Edison to give me a job of some sort." He said, "I will see Edison and put him out." He did not say, "I will keep my eye open for the Edison organization." He said, "There is but one thing in my business in this world that I am determined to have that, and that is a business association with Thomas A. Edison. I will burn all bridges behind me and shape my entire future on it." See, this man was dedicated, focused, committed. He knew what he wanted, and he wasn't going to let nothing stop him. That's what you have to be successful. And again, I say, only 1% of Americans are going to be wealthy, have any resources of that magnitude, and going to be on top of their game plan. Now I'm going to touch on a chapter in this book, chapter 6, the social point of view. Without fear is impossible. Without faith, it is impossible to please God. And without faith, it's impossible for you to become great. You got to believe in yourself. You got to have faith in yourself. The distinguishing characteristic of all really great men and women is an unwavering faith. We see in Lincoln during the dark days of war. We see it in Washington at Valley Forge. We see it in Livingston, the crippled missionary treading the mazes of the dark continents, his soul aflame with determination to let in the light upon the accursed slave trade, which his soul abhorred. We see it in Luther and in Francis Willard, and every man and woman who has attained a place on the muster roll of the great ones of the world. Faith, not a faith in oneself or in one's own powers, but faith in principle, in the something great which holds right and which may be relied upon to give us the victory in due time. Without this faith, it is not possible for anyone to rise to real greatness. The man who has no faith in principle will always be a small man, The man who has no faith in principle will always be a small man. Whether you have this faith or not depends upon your point of view, how you think about yourself. The man who has no faith in principle will always be small. Whether you have this faith or not depends upon your point of view. You must learn to see the world as being produced by evolution, as a something which is evolving and becoming not a finished work. Millions of years ago, God worked in very low and crude forms of life, with very low and crude forms of life. Low and crude, yet each perfect after its kind. Higher and more complex organisms, animal and vegetable, appeared through the successive ages. The earth passed through stage after stage in its unfoldment, each stage perfect in itself and to be succeeded by a higher one. What I wish you to note is that the so-called lower organisms are as perfect after their kind as the higher ones, that the world in Esonin's period was perfect for that period. It was perfect, but God's work was not finished. See, God does an eternal work. It's going to be eternal until you get the glorified body, those that are in the body of Christ. So you have to pursue your destiny with all diligence and never give up, never give out, never quit. But God's work is not finished. This is true of the world today. Physically, socially, and industrially, it is all good and it is all perfect. It is not complete anywhere or in any part. God has gone. It is perfect. This must be your point of view, that the world and all it contains is perfect, though not complete. It's all right with the world. That is the great fact. There is nothing wrong with anything. There is nothing wrong with anybody. All the facts of life you must contemplate from this standpoint. There is nothing wrong with nature. Nature is a great advancing presence. working beneficially for all, for the happiness of all. She is going on talking about nature are all good. She has no evil. She is not completed, for creation is still unfinished. She is growing to give to man even more bountifully than she has given to him in the past. Nature is a partial expression of God, and God is love. He is perfect but not complete. She is perfect but not complete. So of human society and government, what though there are trust and combinations of capital and strikes and lockouts and so on, all these things are part of the forward movement. They are incidental to the evolutionary process of getting society. When it is complete, there will be no more of these inharmonies. It cannot be completed without them. J.P. Morgan is necessary to the coming social order, as the strange animals of the age of reptiles were to the life of the succeeding period. And just as these animals were perfect after their kind, so Morgan is perfect after his kind. Behold, it is all very good. See society, government, and industry. This will sound like rank folly to many people. Perhaps to most people, what, they will say, are not child labor and exploitation of men and women in filthy and unsanitary factories evil things? Aren't saloons evil? Do you mean to say that we shall accept all these and call them good? Child labor and similar things are no more evil in the way of living, and the habits and practices of cave dwellers were evil. His ways were those of a savage age of man's growth. And for that stage, they were perfect. Our industrial practices are those of the savage stage of industry development, and they are also perfect. Our industrial practices are those of the savage stage of industry development. They are also perfect. Nothing better is possible until we see the Our industrial practices are those of the savage stage of industrial development, and they are also perfect. Nothing better is possible until we cease to be mental savages in industry and business and become men and women. This can only come about by the rise of the whole race to a higher conscious level. So saloons and dives, they are getting now what they desire. Whenever they desire more in the way of a higher conscious level, when they deserve way of a higher, pure, more harmonious life, they will receive more. True, they want more now, but they only want more of the things that make for animal enjoyment, and so industry remains in the same savage, brutal animal stage. When the workers begin to rise to the mental plane of living and asking for more out of things that make for life, of the mind, soul, and industry will at once be raised above the plane of savagery and brutality. But it is perfect now upon its plane. Behold, it is all very good. So saloons, dens of vices of the majority of the people desire these things. It is right and necessary that they should have them. When the majority desires a world without such discord, they will create such a world. So long as men and women are on the plane of bestial thought, so long as the social order will be in part discovered. It is all perfect, thoroughly complete. It is all the handiwork of God. Behold, it is all very good. So what it's really saying is this. When you desire to have better, you will. If you desire to walk in ignorance, walk in stupidity, walk as a beast, walk as an imbecile, you will. And as the book was saying, when society decides to come up, when they decide to grow, when they decide they don't want the alcohol, they don't want the drugs, they don't want the child pornography, they don't want all these vices that have hindered them for all their lives, that's when things will change. Because they'll begin to put information in their minds to think on a higher level, to walk on a higher level, to be connected with God in a greater way, so that way they can abound in their greatness. Now, I'm talking about God, the Lord, and all that he can do, all that he will do, and all that he has done. Now, I'm going to say a prayer for all you listening, viewing audience. You say the prayer after me, you will be saved, you will have a change, and you will have more hope in your life. You don't hope and pray, you hope and believe, you pray and do. Father, in the name of Jesus, I come before you today. I've heard Elder Glover talk about being right with you. I'm not saved, but I want you in my heart. Come in and take my hands, my knees, my feet, my eyes. Take my entire body. Use it for your glory. Use it for your abundance. I give you my life now for your will to be done. In Jesus' name, amen. Now, you have said a salvation prayer. Now, I put in the hands, knees, and feet, and eyes. Because when I got saved, I asked God to take my hands, my knees, my feet, my eyes. Hey, man, take everything. My dad's dead. My mom's dead. My grandmother's dead. Come into my life now. I wanted a change. I was going to prison the second time. I didn't want to come back out selling dope, hustling, and so on. So I gave my life to the Lord. He delivered me, set me free, saved me, and helped me be a better human being. Now, I'm a human doing, but I am a human being. And I appreciate every good thing God has given me. And there's going to be so much more awaiting me, because where my mind is at, I'm fixed on my destiny and purpose. All of you have a purpose and destiny, but you've got to know what it is. You've got to pursue it. You've got to get in it. You've got to never give up, never give out, never quit. You are uniquely and wonderfully made, but you have to see yourself that way. You have to believe you are. You have to be willing to do what it takes to achieve that destiny. Now, I'm going to sing a song Billy Preston had out years ago. Nothing from nothing leaves nothing. You got to have something if you want to be with me. Nothing from nothing leaves nothing. You got to have something if you want to be with me. Don't you remember I told you I'm a soldier in the war on poverty? Billy Preston, a phenomenal organist back during the 60s, he lived into the mid-2000s. Billy was an extraordinary musician. He's with God now. He was in Shindig, a show that was out there in the 60s. I'm 62, so I don't mind telling my age. See, I'm transparent. I can say whatever's going on the right way. Now, he was stating nothing from nothing leaves nothing. You got to have something if you want to be with me. He was not going to be involved with a woman that had nothing to show for her life. He was not going to be involved with a woman that had no money, had no resources, had nothing, and he had to build her up and all this. He had resources, but he had to have someone connected with him appropriately that was like-minded, had the same values, had the same character integrity that he had. See, you want less problems in relationship. Well, you got to be willing to put something into it. You got to know who you are. You got to be focused on your destiny. And you can't give in, give out, or quit. You got to love yourself and love God. You can't hate you and how you look. You got to do something about how you look. I look at it this way. I've got bags under my eyes. When time comes, I'm going to a surgeon to take them bags out. Now, my head shows that I have a receding hairline, bald in certain areas. I'm going to connect with Bosley. All they do is take your hair and replace it in areas it's not growing, and it's going to grow because it's where it's growing. So, see, I'm going to enhance myself. I'm going to look the best I can. I'm going to invest into me. I'm investing into my clothes. I'm investing into leathers and suede, and then I'm going to get some things made for me. As the Lord has been telling me for years, I'm putting you on display, and I look at eventually that I will have a place to where I can train young men in how to dress, how to carry themselves, how to speak appropriately, how to treat women right, and maybe women, how to treat men right. I plan on doing that because years ago, a lady told me, David, you ought to have a men's club. You know how to dress, you know how to talk, you know how to carry yourself. Well, I didn't think about it when I was in the game, but the thought makes sense. Too many young men don't know how to carry themselves, sagging, wearing their drawers down. You don't have a clue at who you are. And sagging represents you've been raped in prison because that's where it came from. Any guy that looked fair, looked kind of feminine or didn't look really masculine, he was played off, given candy and given other things. And then when it came time to repay it, if he couldn't, they raped him. They took his manhood. And so therefore, that's when the sagging came, because it meant that you represented somebody. You were somebody's girl. Okay? Now, that's what it means. You've been turned out. You're a homosexual because you've been turned out now. Now you running with your jaw showing, you look ugly. It's stupid. It's ridiculous. No class, no finesse, no destiny, just something that's showing your underwear. Who wants to see your draws? I know I don't. I definitely don't want to see it. You can't get a good job. You can't get in business. You can't get anything worthwhile wearing your underwear showing. Nobody wants to be around that, and no business is going to allow you in. You are someone uniquely, wonderfully made. God's never made no junk. He cares and loves you, but you have to love yourself. Now, here's a song he gave me years ago in prison. It's called Wyatt, it's called Jesus Christ. It's the old Wyatt Earp thing. Those of you that remember the 50s and the 60s, the TV shows, Hugh O'Brien played Wyatt Earp. Jesus Christ, Jesus Christ, brave, courageous, and bold. Long live his fame, long live his glory, and long may his story be told. Don't you know he loves you so? Praise him every day. Long live his fame. Long live his glory, and long may his story be told. Praise the Lord, praise the Lord, praise him every day. Long live his fame, long live his glory, and long may his story be told. See, he's worthy to be lifted up. He's worthy to be praised because he's given me everything I have, from a car to furniture, the opportunity to connect with the multimillionaire in regards of Christian Nobel. He's a sponsor, Tom Ray. He's a sponsor, Tyler Ray. He's a sponsor for this broadcast. And I praise God that we both understand like-minded. We both understand the same things. We've been from the same direction. And I thank God that I was a pimp, hustler, and a dope dealer, because that enabled me to generate money, enabled me to understand business, enabled me to understand how to talk to people, enabled me to stay focused, committed, to get off my behind and get up, get busy, get out in the streets and get my money, to take care of what I had to do. I couldn't depend on nobody to help me. I had to help myself. So I thank God for all that I was to become all that I am. And I praise him for the things that are happening on my behalf. I was downtown today, looked around, found $6, $5 folded and a dollar. I praise God for that, because that way I've got more than I had when I started. And this is a little saying I have. I'm somewhere in the future, and you look much better than you look right now. I'm somewhere in the future, and you look much better than you look right now. I'm somewhere in the future, and I look much better than I look right now. See, you're going in the future. You're going to look better than you are now because it's ahead instead of behind. You want to be above and not beneath. But see, you got to make the decision, viewing audience, to get off your behind, get up, get down, get positive. Now, if you like to book me for engagements, such as women's groups, church ministries, youth organizations, at-risk programs, reentry programs, contact me at area code 402-813-2339. Or you can write me at P.O. Majestic Productions, P.O. Box 111, 402, Omaha, Nebraska, 68111. Now, if you are impressed, you've heard these broadcasts for at least since October, every Friday at 11 o'clock. If the Lord impresses you to send a love gift, send it. If he impresses you to bless me with thousands or hundreds or whatever, send it, because it helps me defray the cost of this radio station and that I can keep on the air. My mission statement states, helping people help themselves to reach their potential. Every man and woman have potential in you, and it's my blessing to find out what that potential is and help you get it. Now, these messages go out all over the world, live streamed in every part of the country. You can see me at 11 o'clock, channel 1690 AM to 1. You got to go online because it's not on a radio channel. But next week, we'll have FM streamed as well as AM. That means I'll be going live stream AM and FM all over the world, a double portion of this anointing. And see, I'm glad God's put a captivating mantle on my life to where as I talk, people feel the power of God, their attention is being held, and they begin to look at who they are. See, you got greatness on the inside of you, but you got to let it out. You got to read books to re-educate your mind. Barnes & Noble has self-improvement books that help you think like a millionaire, to do like a millionaire, and believe like one. So you got to believe for things. You can't just think it's going to happen by osmosis. No. It takes you to get up, get down, to get busy, to do what you have to do in order to accomplish what you want to accomplish. You are your own best friend or your own worst enemy. And you are the one that has to make it or break it. Now, here's something by Napoleon Hill. I bargained with life for a penny, and life would pay no more. However, I begged that evening when I counted my scanty store. For life is a just employer. It gives you what you ask. But once you have set the wages, why, you must bear the task. I worked for a menial hire, only to learn dismay that any wage I ask of life life would willingly pay. So that means if you ask for millions, you can't get it. But you have to have the right motives. You have to have the right desires. You can't look at it lording upon yourself. You got to look at reaching out to people, helping them, and advancing different things that's necessary. It's like if I had millions and billions, I would build a financial foundation to help people to achieve their destiny and to show them how to do it. But they have to be willing to take responsibility for their life and to achieve what there is to achieve. Now, here's some more information. Read yourself into a fortune. This book contains money-making secrets that can change your life. This is Think and Grow Rich, Napoleon Hill. Think and Grow Rich, based on the author's famed Law of Success, represents the distilled wisdom and distinguishment of great wealth and achievement. Andrew Carnegie's magic formula for success was the direct inspiration for this book. Carnegie demonstrated its soundness when his coaching brought fortunes to those young men whom he had disclosed his secret. This book will teach you that secrets in the secret of other great men like him. It will show you not only what to do, but how to do it. If you learn and apply the simple basic techniques revealed here, you will have mastered the secret of true and lasting success, and you may have whatever you want in life. See, you can have anything you want if you got the right motives and put God first. He will bless you to do what you need to do. Now, here's a testament to perseverance. R.U. Delby was caught by gold fever, brought machinery. He and his uncle mined the mine. After weeks of labor, he was rewarded by the discovery of the shining oil. He needed machinery, so he and his uncle went, covered up the mine, covered their tracks, went back home, got machinery with help of relatives, and went back to work the mine. The first car of oil was shipped to the smelter. The return proved they had one of the richest mines in Colorado. A few more cars of that ore would clear their debt. Then would come the big killing in profits. Down went the drills. Up went the hopes of Darby and his uncle. Then something happened. The vein of gold disappeared. They had come to the end of the rainbow. And the pot of gold was no longer there. They drilled on desperately, trying to pick up the vein again, to no avail. Finally decided to quit. They sold the machinery to a junk man for a few $100s. And took the train back home. The junk man called in a mining expert to look at the mine and do some calculating. The engineer advised that the prior had failed because the owners were not familiar with fault lines. His calculations showed that the vein would be found just 3 feet from where the Dalbys had stopped drilling. That is exactly where it was found. The junk man took millions of dollars in ore from the mine because he knew enough to seek expert counsel before giving up. See, you gotta be willing to go the extra mile. You gotta get information that will help you achieve your destiny. Now, you're never too old. I'm 62. I'm never going to be too old to achieve my destiny. I'm never going to be too old to fulfill my purpose. If you're 70 or 80, as long as you got breath in you, God has use for you. You got use for yourself. Instead of sitting your butt in a rocking chair and sitting back and doing nothing, like James Brown used to say, dull night, just ain't cutting, talking loud and saying nothing. You got to be productive. Now, this is from Napoleon Hill's book. I really realize that no wealth or position can long endure unless built upon truth and justice. Therefore, I will engage in no transaction which does not benefit all whom it affects. I will succeed by attracting to myself the forces I wish to use and the cooperation of other people. I will induce others to serve me because of my willingness to serve others. I will eliminate hatred, envy, jealousy, selfishness, and cynicism by developing love for all humanity, because I know that a negative attitude towards others can never bring me success. I will cause others to become in me, to believe in me, because I will believe in them and in myself. I will sign my name on this formula, commit it to memory, and respect it repeat it aloud once a day with full faith that it will gradually influence my thoughts, actions, so that I will become self-reliant and successful person. See, the thing is, when you read information like this, what it does, it helps you become self-active. Self-active means you get off your behind, get busy, do what it takes, do what you need to do, and then the law of attraction will work on your behalf, work for you, work with you, help you accomplish the destiny that you have. But you've got to be willing to do something. You've got to be focused on getting your destiny accomplished. You've got to be a man or woman of character and integrity. You can't give up. You can't give in. You can't give out. You can't quit. You've got to be willing to pursue your God-ordained purpose for being on the planet in the first place. I'll be back in a moment after these messages. Now we have Wolf Brothers, Tom Kirstenbaum of Wolf Brothers Western Wear, 7001 Dodge Street, phone number area code 402-558-3005, serving Seattle since 1950. When you come in, Wolf Brothers, you smell the fine Corinthian leather. That's all that you smell in the place. They have expert salespersons there that are schooled in every area of the products, from belts to shoes, exotic boots, Shelby coats, leather, fine, beautiful leather jackets. They have Western shirts, hats, rodeo-style hats. You can make the Roy Rogers crown out of those hats. They have everything for the Western enthusiast. Now, their boots are snakeskin, crocodile, alligator, eel skin. I think they have eel skin. They even have leather boots. They have all kind of snake and ostrich. Ostrich has the quills on the back, and the stomach has swirls. So they have excellent quality. Not only that, Tom has sales on his boots year-round. $300 boots on sale for $300. Now, you put them on layaway, and then the thing is, if they don't have it in your size and they're on sale, he can order it for you in your size. Now, go by and tell him David Glover sent you. He's open pretty much 7 days a week right there on 7001 Dodge Street. It's got a little Western saloon type building. It's not a saloon, but he has the Western flavor. Now, Red City Brothers Auto, Monday through Friday, 8 a.m. to 6 p.m. Car sales, he even has warranties, car detailing. They take pride in producing quality work and providing for our customers and with excellent service. We do have the most affordable prices in town for our customers' convenience. We also offer pickup and delivery. So you can call and you pick up your car and bring it back to you. Service from anywhere in Omaha. We are sure you will be a happy customer in doing business with our car wash and detail company. So now, contact them, Big City Brothers Auto. They have excellent quality vehicles. They have them on Dodge Street on 72nd. And you've seen it many times going by, going towards Baker's on 72nd. Go by and tell them David Glover sent you. And pick up on the quality of their products. Now, we also have Steve's Barbecue Pit, a favorite of mine. Steve smoked two Cornish hens for me, and it was so juicy, the juice ran through the tinfoil. He wrapped them up in tightly and into the bag. Now, he can smoke turkeys, chickens, goose, any fowl he can smoke. And he could do pork loins. He has those for $15, half a loin for $15.40, eighth of a loin for $9. He also has ribs, full rack of ribs for $20.60, half a rack for $14. He's located at 2414 Patrick Avenue. Skeets is down the street. He's just a few feet across the street from Skeets. He's got a white building. Tell him David Glover sent you. And he's open Wednesday through Saturday, 11 to 8 p.m., Sundays from 3 to 6. He wants to be available for the church crowd, that they get the opportunity to come in and get some excellent quality barbecue. So I'm going to get with him on Wednesday or Tuesday, drop it off. I'm going to drop a goose, not duck, and two Cornish hens. And I'll pick him up the day of Christmas Eve. And they'll be ready, ripe, and ready to eat. So I encourage you. It's so tender and moist, the juice just runs off it. Now, last but not least, this is a man I really feel proud of. Christian Nobel, owner Tom Ray, in Regency Parkway. His furs are reasonably priced. That means that you can go in on different coats that you would like made. He has pieces of fur that you can have a coat made. I'm going to do that. I want a sable coat. I want a mink coat. I want a fox coat. And I want a coyote coat. First, I'll get the vest. Now, the vest might be about $200 or $300. And you can put them on layaway. You go to Overland, no put down on them. But everything is pricey. It's $2,000 or $3,000 for the vest. And if you get it on sale, it's $1,600. Well, with Tom, with Tyler, it's less because he can use pieces. After they made the coat, he can take pieces of fur, make whatever you want. And tell him David Glover sent you. When you're coming into Omaha, Nebraska, maybe from out of town, plan your trip. Come in, spend some money with him. You'll be glad you did. They take your measurements, make it for you, and you come in for a fitting, and then you get the product. Because years ago, back in the 80s, I got everything I had was tailor-made. Jumpsuits, shirt jacks, slacks, vest suits. Everything was cut. So I'm aware of making clothes, and I haven't dealt with furs, but I'm going to learn about them because I enjoy the fur industry. Now, you can contact him at 402-343-9406. And if you do connect with him on layaway, take care of your business, pay him his money. Don't play games and go in and say you're going to do something. Don't. You take care of your business. You drop it with him. He's already making a way for you to get affordable quality mink, sable, maybe even coyote, and other fur items. Now, you are someone uniquely, wonderfully made. And I'm thankful that God's blessed me to have this time with you to do these broadcasts to let you know who you are and where you're going. See, you are the one that ensures your destiny. You're the one that's got to know who you are, where you're going, and not to give up, not to give out, and never quit. But you have to make the decision you're going to do what it takes. You have to make the decision that you're going to take care of your responsibility. You got to make the decision that you're going for the best life has to offer. It's yours, and it's got your name on it, but it's up to you. See, God ain't even going to do it for you. He'll help you, but you got to be the one that's man enough to get up, take care of your business, do what's responsible to accomplish the destiny that God's ordained you to accomplish. You are someone uniquely, wonderfully made, but you got to see yourself that way. You got to love yourself enough to take care of your responsibilities. You got to love yourself enough to care about yourself and to be functional, consistent, and to be responsible. Because as you do, I can't help but see you at the top, because you are prepared to go to the top. You are prepared to walk in your destiny and to abound in your greatness. So I wish you the best, viewing audience. I wish you all good things come to you. I hope everything works out right for you. You are someone uniquely, wonderfully made. I love you with the unconditional love of God. And I'll be here again next Friday, probably live stream on AM and FM. And there's no telling how things are going to work out. There's no telling how God's going to move on me and through me to bless you with the information that I'm giving. You are someone uniquely, wonderfully made. You are a vessel of honor, me for the master's use. But you got to see yourself that way. You got to know who you are. You got to love yourself enough to never give up, to never quit, to stay down, to be dedicated for your purpose to be fulfilled. And if you do, I'll see you at the top, because that's the only place you have to go, is at the top. Life is to be lived. Enjoy. This is Steve Winwood, taking it to the end, but it's still the beginning. You are someone uniquely wonderfully made. And until we meet again, this is Elder David Glover, getting ready to sign off for Majestic Productions. Be blessed, be encouraged, know who you are, and stay focused, because you're walking in your destiny, but it's up to you to pursue. Until we meet again, God bless you. And be encouraged. Test, test, test.